Welcome back, cartography fans. Before we move on from locating ourselves on the surface with the easy latitude and longitude, we must pause and take a look at the USPLSS, or the PLSS for short, but either way, it is the United States Public Land Survey System. Look, this episode may seem tedious, but by the end, I hope you will have a much greater appreciation for the system and its global influence. The essential point is that the USPLSS is the first time a nation tried to survey its land into easily distributed parcels in a systematic manner. The PLSS was developed by none other than Thomas Jefferson, and was implemented after the Revolutionary War when there was a desire to reward veterans with these land parcels, and a need to sell other parcels to raise money for the fledgling nation. We start by laying down a set of baselines and principal meridians, and you'll notice that the Northeast was already settled, so it's not under this system, and Texas was its own nation, so it is not either. But the rest of the country, with baselines, are parallel to each other, going from east to west, and thus are kind of corresponding to latitude lines, and the principal meridians are on and corresponding to longitude lines. There is a baseline very close to the location of the Colorado School of Mines to the north in the town of Boulder, Colorado. Locals know it as Baseline Road. So the system starts from a starting point on the Pennsylvania-Ohio-West Virginia border. These major grid lines are measured out from that point, but we need to go more specific to designate any parcels of land, so we start at the nearest intersection point of a baseline and principal meridian to your location, and then we use these 6 mile by 6 mile squares, 36 square miles, to count off to our location. Each of these 36 square mile blocks are called a township. Maybe you've driven across our country and seen a sign saying something like, "Now entering Crystal Township, Iowa." So we locate ourselves as being X number of townships to the north or south of the nearest baseline. We said the baseline for our golden quadrangle map was close to our north, so it isn't surprising that when we look at our map, and by the way, PLSS information is given in red in and around the edges of the map, we see that this map is partly covering T2S, two townships to the south of the baseline, and the rest is T3S, Township 3 South. Now we see how many of these township squares we range to the east or west of the nearest principal meridian. Instead of talking townships north or south, we talk of ranges to the east or west. The township offset was given on the left and right sides of the map, and logically the ranges are noted on the top and bottom of the map. Our map covers parts of Range 69 West and Range 70 West. But 36 square miles is still too large an area to consider a governmental parcel of land, so we proceed to divide it up into 36 1-by-1 mile or 1 square mile blocks, starting in the northeast corner, going across the road, then dropping down and zigzagging back and forth down the township, ending in the southeast corner. Each of these sections of the township is called a section. Section 18, section 19, section 20. The water tank we will look at on our hike up North Table Mountain is located in section 21 of Township 3 South, Range 70 West. But this still isn't specific enough. And so we take this section and we split it into quarters. Our water tank is clearly in the northeast quarter of section 21, Township 3 South, Range 70 West. Guess what? Not specific enough. And so we break this quarter of a section into quarters, or 16ths of a section. Our water tank is barely in the southeast quarter of the northeast quarter of section 21, Township 3 South, Range 70 West, and we're done. Or we can do this the other way. Tell me what is located at this PLSS designation. Northwest quarter of the northwest quarter of section 12, township 3 south, range 70 west. It's easiest to start from the large, and this is the section of the map that is in township 3 south, range 70 west, section 12, and the northwest quarter, and the northwest quarter, and Boyd Lake. Okay, honestly, how much are you singing the praises of Thomas Jefferson right now? But realize how land used to be surveyed? Usually with geographic markers like, start at the tree at the top of the hill and go down this distance to the bend in the creek and then over to this limestone outcrop over at this distance. Sure, it's a lot more organic and stupid. These old school geographical markers are subject to change, and the resultant parcels of land have no uniformity in their size, and people can be very creative to cheat the system. But here we have a set coordinate system with uniform parcels of land, a quarter of a section of a township of a range, which comes out to 40 acres. Perhaps you've heard the terms, maybe in American movies, about the top 40, the back 40, front 40, lower 40. And the lower 40, by the way, is the 40-acre parcel with the lowest elevation in a section, and thus the place most likely to have streams or ponds, and thus the value of possessing the lower 40. Or perhaps you know of the post-Civil War reparations for American slaves, 40 acres and a mule, from which Spike Lee adopted the name for his film company. After the best land had been sold and distributed, the less desirable lands were often sold in 80-acre, or even 160-acre, a whole quarter of a section. When you drive across many rural parts of our country, you see road systems with regular grid-like intersections with basic 1, 3, and 6-mile spacings. These roads are just following the USPLSS grids. In the end, this system was so successful and useful to its purposes that it's praised around the world, and it's used as a model in any new land reform measures. I mean, even the 40-acre parcel was a scientifically planned space, deriving from the use at that time of chains to measure off distances, and how much work it would take to survey any land plot thusly. So scoff away, but it was as revolutionary as the war that preceded it, and as globally influential.